So let's start by considering Napster. In its first incarnation, Napster was a peer-to-peer file sharing system. And it was mostly used, actually, to illegally share MP3s, which is also the reason why it got sued and later on it basically ceased operations. But nevertheless, I think Napster is an interesting example of mixed architecture. And I'm going to illustrate the way Napster works by showing you here the basic configuration of Napster and the interactions between its elements. So let's look at how such interaction can take place for the three peers shown here. And in this case, peer A and B are the only ones really involved in the action. So let's look at a typical sequence of events for the Napster system. We have peer A that will start by registering here with the content directory. Peer B will also register with the content directory. And when these two peers register, the content directory will know what kind of content they can provide. Later on, peer A will request a song. And one first observation that we can make based on this interaction is the fact that up to now, this is a purely client-server system. This is the client, this is the client, and this is the server. And the interaction is a typical client-server interaction. But now we're at the point in which things start to change a little bit. At this point, after peer A has requested the song, the peer and content directory will look up its gigantic index and will see that peer B actually has the song that peer A requested. So it will send to peer A a handle that peer A can use to connect directly to peer B. So this is where the system is not longer a client-server system, because at this point, the two peers are connected directly. So at this point, we have a peer-to-peer interaction. And after getting the request from peer A, then peer B will start sending the content to peer A. And I said earlier that one of the useful things about representing an architecture and the interactions within an architecture graphically is the fact that it allows you to spot possible problems. And in this case, by representing the Napster architecture in this way and by studying how things work, we can see that there's an issue with the architecture of Napster that will not make this architecture scale. As some of you might have already noticed, this peer and content directory is a single point of failure and is very likely to cause problems when the number of peers grows too large. Because at that point, there's going to be too many requests to the peer and content directory, and the peer and content directory is unlikely to be able to keep up with all the requests. So some changes in the architecture will have to be made. In the case of Napster, we didn't see this problem occurring because, as I said earlier, Napster got sued and ceased operation before the problem actually manifested. Now, looking at the system from an architectural style perspective, we can see that Napster was a hybrid architecture with both client-server and peer-to-peer element. And something I would like to stress here is that this is not at all uncommon. So in real-world, non-trivial architectures, it is very common to see multiple styles used in the same system. The next system that we will consider, Skype, is instead an example of a well-designed, almost purely peer-to-peer system.